Water change time. Just got through with about a 95% water change. And look at my new babies I've added to the tank. I was really upset and broken up about losing my large Aranda, who was an orange Aranda. The Hara was his name. And because of COVID-19, I had not been able to replace him. And these three babies here have been so melancholy ever since he passed away. So I'm trying to pep up their spirits with some of these lively comets. These are also goldfish. They are single-tailed, double-tailed, but single-tailed. Goldies, which is considered common goldies, but these guys are in no ways looking common. They've come in some very beautiful color varieties here that I have. So I've got some really interesting plain comet goldfish. But they're very pretty. I think they're making the tank look so much more lively and cheerful with the flowing, fluttering movements that they have. And I will say that I did research and understand that these varieties can get quite large. A lot of people buy comets for feeder fish, but these are so beautiful. I believe that they're very pretty. I mean, look at that. Almost look like koi, you know. They can be kind of compared to some of the basic koi that you can find in beauty, as far as I'm concerned. And, you know, they can get a little bit larger, and people use them as feeder fish sometimes, which I think is ridiculous, but, you know, they do. And some people actually love these in ponds, in small ponds. And so my remedying of the possibility of them getting larger is I will probably get another tank and upgrade. Look at these two. Really orange ones are pretty. This one has got a little white on them and white on the tail. I mean, that's a common goldfish. But to me, I think they're very pretty. That's a very pretty one right here. Also, very bright orange. With a little bit of white on the tail. Very beautiful. Hey, sugar and sequins. There's sugar. There's sequins. That's my baby girl who's so fat and big now. I mean, she's ridiculously big. And even Oasis has gotten larger since around the holidays, in which I had gotten him around that time. He's gotten fatter, and he seems to be excited about all of the new friends. It's taken Sugar a little bit of time. Sugar kind of tried to chase some out of the way and ran into the corner and sulked a little bit. As if though he was mad to have all of this going on in here. Like, who are these people taking over my tank? But I think he's warming up. And Sequins is always kind of laid back. She says, whatever. You know, whatever's whatever. But yes, she's getting used to it. But look at these guys. I mean, they come in so many varieties of colors. And they're considered the basic goldfish. Comet, C-O-M-E-T, variety. But I think they're beautiful. I am a fan of goldfish, fancies in particular, but I do like goldfish no matter how basic some aquarium hobbyist may think of them to be. I find them to be very easy to incorporate into a tank as a first-time aquarium fish-keeping aquarium enthusiast, excuse me. And, you know, they're easy to learn, they're easy to care for, but the only difficulty in their caring for is that you do have to keep the water changed and cleaned because they are messy. But that's about the only difficulty about goldies, in my opinion. They eat a variety of things. They're more herbivores. They're not really supposed to have a lot of protein-based foods. They're not really supposed to, but every once in a while, I occasionally give them bloodworms. I used to feed them boiled egg whites chopped up, but I learned that that isn't the best thing to feed them because they are herbivores. But they'll eat fruit. They'll eat fresh greens. If you parboil them for like a few minutes, and don't boil all of the nutrients out, but just enough to soften them so that they can, you know, easily mash them up and grind them up and eat them. But they eat, you know, they'll eat what you eat. Peas, you just have to peel the peas skin layer off. But peas, bananas, sweet potatoes, collard greens, baby spinach, turnips, these guys will eat, okay, along with whatever foods that you can buy. Some of my favorites to feed them is spirulina, flakes, if I do give them flakes, but most of the time I give them pellets, sinkable pellets, and I'm trying to reach for some of the best that I like. This is Sinking Goldfish XL, made by Azutaki Akari. Yeah. Hikari, I guess that's how you pronounce it. But yes, this is the best stuff. Well, close to the best. There is one other brand by Saki Akari, which is the color enhancing, but at the time I could not get that ordered. So that's the second best situation on, you know, helping to keep the color vibrant in them, and is a good brand in terms of, you know, feeding them the best. That's the best. Spirulina also. I also get spirulina sheets, which I don't know what the brand is, because my actual place that I get them from, he just gets them by the sheets from somewhere. I don't know. So, and, you just put them on a little clip and just put them on a suction clip and let the sheet just hang there, and they'll nibble at it all day. Those are good things to feed them. And, you know, they're easy to feed as far as I'm concerned. If you run out of actual commercial brand food, like I said, they can eat fresh foods. You know, they're quite easy going to feed. And to me, they're pretty easy to care for. They're very loving and sweet. You know, they don't really normally give much of a problem, especially when it comes down to introducing fish to the tank. You know, not unless you introduce a fish that seems to be aggressive itself, or, you know, if you're not careful and you introduce a fish or select a fish that has some kind of illness that might make your existing Goldies sick. Other than that, when it comes down to introducing fish to the tank, they're very laid back. They never have an issue of wanting to fight or be aggressive to fish when you introduce fish. Now, like I said, a little sulking out of sugar, and sugar's still trying to warm up to all the new friends. But other than that, you see no aggression, you see no fighting, you see no, you know, trying to push or shove anybody around. These guys have really warmed up to their environment here, and they're just having a good old time. They're just really enjoying this big tank. I got them out of a 20-gallon tank out of the pet supermarket, actually. I was going to put gouramis in here with them because I saw somebody's success with gouramis and Goldies. So I bought a few. I bought 5 gourami. And then I saw this man getting these comets for his pond. He has a small pond out back. And I said, well, you know, these are goldfish. And some of these, as I was watching him scoop some out with some of these varieties of black and, you know, white and just all the beautiful striations that they seem to have. Let's see, this one's golden black. Really pretty. I mean, you can almost compare that to the likes of a of some of the koi that you can see, you know. In terms of beauty, these, look at these two here. And these are what you consider plain old goldfish, comet goldfish. These are fast swimmers, yes. So feeding, you'll have to probably feed a variety of types of food so that my big guys who do not swim fast can graze their pellets. And then I'll throw in like spirulina flakes so these guys can, you know, just quickly snap up the flakes. That way, if I feed two varieties, then, you know, there won't be a struggle for my big guys who do not, and gal, who do not swim fast. Won't be a struggle for them to eat and actually get something to eat. So that will be my strategy. But I think this really looks beautiful in the tank. It's really making my tank look and feel more lively right now since I have lost Dahara, and, you know, just looks so empty. So, and also too, you know, it's just something to liven up my spirits because of all this COVID-19 and depressing type of situations going on. Something that makes you happy, and this is what makes me happy, you know. It's one of the things in my life that makes me happy and that I love to come home to. This right here, it's a mood cheerer upper. It's the way I look at it. Yeah, so I'm very happy that I did make the decision to get the comets. And if they do get bigger, because they can, I can just upgrade and get another tank, you know, or I can give some of them away. I do have a supplier that probably will take them because they get a lot of pond and, you know, large aquariums they sell a lot of, and they get a lot of pond people who come in there for pond supplies, and they would readily accept them, some of them, if I have to give some away. And also, too, like I said, I can always get another tank, which is, you know, okay with me, because I was thinking to get another tank, specifically to get African cichlids. I have been kind of crushing on African cichlids now for a while, but I haven't made that decision yet because, like I've said, African cichlids are one of the types of fish that are difficult to deal with, you know, and like I've said about Goldies being so easy, and they're very beautiful and interesting to watch in a tank, in my opinion, no matter how common people think they are. And, you know, some people think they're boring and common. I don't. I think they come in very beautiful varieties. My fish are very beautiful, I believe. And they're easy to care for. They're messy, but they're easy going. Cichlids, I have been kind of delaying on because cichlids take a lot of, you know, effort and all of the drama that they may present. You know, they are very aggressive fish. They fight one another, and they fight to the death. You know, they'll kill one another and that sort of thing. So, you know, you don't want to invest money, which they can be kind of pricey to get per fish. You don't want to invest money in fish that ultimately wind up dead within a day or two if they're not getting along. And then, you know, you have to know which varieties go with which in a tank because of the, you know, the aggression. And there's aggressiveness in mating. There's so much that you have to go through in difficulty in enjoying a tank with cichlids that you have to go through the extra, you know, drama in order to have a tank with those fish. These are very easygoing, you know. Very, you know, sweet kind of fish that are very easy and laid back to take care of and come in very beautiful varieties. In my opinion, they're ideal. I think my tank is beautiful. So, whomever thinks they're boring, bah humbug. That's your opinion. So for now, I'm just going to end this video, and I just wanted to do an update on what's new in my 55 gallon and show off the new babies. Yeah. Oh, look at that one. That one is so bright orange. My camera doesn't do it any justice. It is so deep and bright orange. That one was really pretty. And this one, it's got like a white spot on its dorsal. Its dorsal was a little tattered, but I'll be using Melafix and Pemifix, and that'll clear up. He's got that one little white dot on his dorsal fin. That's not ick. That's an actual color part of his pattern. But yes, they all are just really pretty, I think. They're all in the corner over here where you can't really see them the best for the glare. Sorry for the glare. But yeah. I'm happy. I'm happy with it right now. And like I said, I may be changing the situation, but for now, I'm very happy with it. So that's my update. Right, Oasis, right, Sequins. Sequins has that little damage still on her tail fin. She was like a rescue for me. I know you guys see that, but she's gotten so big and so beautiful. I just wanted to let that be known. How great she looks, even though she does have that one little damage on her tail fin. But yes, she's gotten big. It's unbelievably how big she has gotten.